all about the clapback. Get your boss whack, Premier's funeral on Snapchat. Ha! You now tuned into the bad guy.
Big plate, big dinner, bitch, I'm a made nigga. Ballin' hobby, trust nobody, me and my grave digger. I'ma have it all, I'ma have it all.
What's good, y'all? Fist Vegas, the hardest voice in sports. Go ahead, hit that like button and subscribe to the Fist, you know, while you at it. Y'all know what time it is. If you ain't with it, you best get with it. Now let's rock. Listen, hit that sub button. Alright? Hit that sub button. Join this Fist Unit Army. Get Fist Unit tough. We ain't playing out here. We mobbing this season. Alright? With that being said, congratulations to my man Jameis. I'm so happy he won the job officially. You know what I'm saying? I called it. I've called it since the day they signed Jameis. I said this is the greatest offseason acquisition in Saints history. Well, besides Drew Brees. Besides Drew Brees, it's the greatest acquisition in Saints history because he'll be your quarterback the next decade. So the Saints don't have to worry about being trash for the foreseeable future because they just got a quarterback who's about to enter his prime. Jameis is a damn good quarterback. And most Saints fans know that shit. They didn't have to play against him for 4 years or 5 years, however long he was in Tampa Bay. So the Saints fans know he not garbage. Dude threw for 5,200 yards, man. You can't be trash and throw for 5,200 yards. It's not possible. It ain't possible. And what bothers me with Jameis is it's okay for Brett Favre to throw interceptions, but not Jameis. Every single person slurps Brett Favre. Oh, look at Brett Favre. He's a big kid. Oh, look at Brett Favre for the love of the game. Shut the hell up. That mofo threw more picks than anybody. That's all he did was throw picks. Soul-crushing picks. I'm a Giants fan. He threw an interception straight to Corey Webster that sent my Giants to a Super Bowl. Hell, this is a Saints video. Didn't Brett Favre throw an interception and sent the Saints to the Super Bowl in 2009? But ain't nobody want to talk about that. They just care about Jameis Winston interceptions. So when Jameis Winston throw 30 touchdowns and 5,200 yards, he's a bum. When this dude Brett Favre was out there throwing 30 interceptions, ain't nobody say shit. So I hate the double standard. It bothers me. The fact that Tampa Bay threw Jameis away like he was nothing, it bothers me. And you know, the beauty of the situation is, as a, if you're a Saints fan, right, you get to troll Tampa Bay. You know Tom Brady not going to be nice forever. There's going to come a point in time where Jameis is like in MVP conversations, throwing 5,000 yards a season, and Tampa Bay is going to be going back to the sucking mirrors because they don't got a quarterback. All this shit is over when Brady leaves. When Brady's washed, it's over. You feel me? I personally think they gave up on Jameis too quick. Jameis Winston is going to be the Saints quarterback for the foreseeable future. We're going to be going into 2033, and Jameis will still be in New Orleans throwing darts all over the field. And I don't want to take a shot at Drew Brees. We all love Drew Brees, but God knows there would be no Antonio Callaway if Drew Brees is still the quarterback. Brees couldn't push the ball downfield the last 2 or 3 years of his career. He just couldn't. There would be no Antonio Callaway. Everybody want to say Traquan is trash, including myself. But yo, Traquan might be nice with Jameis because Traquan wants to get down the field. Brees couldn't go down the field. Everybody think Michael Thomas can only catch slants. Yo, Michael Thomas might really be able to get down the field to make some shit happen, but we'll never know because Drew Brees couldn't push the ball. It's a new day in New Orleans, man. Who that nation y'all should be celebrating? Eating some good seafood. You know what I'm saying? I really want some good seafood, man. I ain't gonna lie. I've been fiending for some good seafood. I really want some bomb ass seafood. But I think the Saints can still win a division now that Jameis is the quarterback. You know, I was a little concerned with the Taysom Hill thing because I didn't know what kind of backdoor deal that Sean Payton had. I didn't know. I was a little nervous, like, not because Taysom Hill is better than Jameis. It's just favoritism's a bitch. You know what I'm saying? So you never know. But it's good to see Jameis won. Michael Thomas will be back around week 6, week 7. He'll probably look like, you know, Michael Thomas around like week 9. I say around week 8, week 9, Michael Thomas will look like himself. I remember when he first happened, I said give him 10 weeks. He's probably going to miss the first 6, 7 weeks of the season, and then give him a couple weeks to get the round in the form. Michael Thomas, but for the last half of the season, Michael Thomas will be putting up his regular 10 catches a game. And that's all that matters. The Saints will have Michael Thomas for the home run stretch. I don't expect them to ride Kamara like a lot of people do. I think Sean Payton is going to bomb that ball all game long. I think it's going to look a lot like prime Drew Brees years with Sean Payton just dialing them up. I don't think the Saints are going to just run the ball all game. I think they're going to try and push the ball. Sean Payton has a quarterback with talent. He's not just going to run the ball. It's not Sean Payton DNA. It's just run the ball all game. Now that he knows Jameis has an arm, Sean Payton already drawing up crazy ass shit to get Callaway the ball down the field. They're going to push the ball. The Saints are going to put up points. That pass rush with Cam Jordan is still reckless, so they're going to be causing havoc. You saw what they did to Goldilocks, Trevor Lawrence. They put the pressure on him. Dennis Allen, he dialed up them blitzes. So I expect the Saints to still compete for the division. I don't think Tampa Bay is going to be this unstoppable force that everybody thinks they're going to be, because Tom Brady didn't look that good in the playoffs. He threw 3 picks in the second half versus Green Bay. And everybody in New Orleans knows if that bum Jared Cook didn't fumble the ball, the Saints were going to win that game. So I'm not really that scared of a Buccaneer team that the New Orleans Saints swept last year. They swapped them, got the brooms out, and one of them losses was ugly. You know what I'm saying? One of them losses, they had to get a doctor surgically remove the Saints' foot from up Tom Brady's ass. It was bad. So, shout out to Sean Payton for doing the right thing. Can't wait to see the Jameis Winston era begin in 2 weeks. They can beat Green Bay. You know what I'm saying? They can beat Green Bay. Saints ain't scared of no damn Green Bay. So, you know what I'm saying? We going to see what happens. The 12th at 4:30. I think that's the 4 o'clock, 4:30 game. We're going to get it popping. Saints ain't scared of no damn Green Bay. But that's it. That's all, though. Subscribe to the unit. If you rocking with me, my name is Fist Vegas, and I approve this message.